Hi guys, welcome to this week's Mad Skills Masterclass. My name's Fieldey and I'm going to be showing you my techniques for painting fur on animals and also markings. I'm going to be painting a Jaguar as an example and I'm using acrylic paint. Just a reminder, if you use any of these techniques from this series, please hashtag Mad Skills Masterclass so I can take a look. To begin with, I'm just laying down some base colors of yellow ochre and burnt sienna to start building up the paint layers of my Jaguar. I'm roughly blocking in the dark and the light areas, and for the shadows, I'm using a mix of Prussian blue and raw umber. So check out the link above if you want to know more about how to create shadows and highlights. This stage doesn't have to be perfect. It's just laying down some color so that you can start to build up a nice strong color base for the acrylics. Now I'm going to start building up the layers to make the Jaguar look more 3D, so adding in some shading and adding in some highlights. So you might notice that the Jaguar has no spots yet. I'm actually going to add them in at the end. I'm laying down my mid color of the yellow ochre and burnt sienna, and while that's still wet, I'm mixing in lighter and darker colors and blending them back to each other. The aim here is to build up the layers of paint so they look bright and less transparent, and to start to refine and blend the dark and light areas into the mid fur color. I've actually completed the area around the left eye here so you can see how it's going to look, and the base colors have been added to the middle of the face. I'm adding in my highlight colors using a flat brush and I'm flicking the paint, following the growth pattern of the fur around the eyes. I then blend the new lighter color back into the mid-tone so it merges seamlessly into the artwork. When I'm blending these two areas together, I'm using the flat edge of the brush to give the effect of fur overlapping. I like to make sure the brush bristles have separated a little bit to give the feeling of clumps of fur. So old splayed brushes are great for doing fur effects. The eyes of a portrait are normally the natural focal point, and I like to put a bit more detail in there. I'm switching to a smaller flat brush to add in the hair detail around the eye. The air around the eye is normally lighter in the big cats, and the hair grows out from around the eye. So it's important that you check out your reference photo and try to copy the direction the hair is growing. It will also help to explain the 3D form of the cat and it looks more realistic. For sharper, smaller hairs, I use a narrow edge of the brush. I'm not trying to paint every single individual hair. I'm trying to give the effect of multiple hairs making up the animal's coat. I switch to a really small brush to add in little white highlight details around the mouth. So sometimes picking out small individual hairs will help make the animal look more furry. The bulk of the fur is finished, so now I just want to add in some fine long hairs. This is a great brush for that. It's a long-haired sable brush. To add in the spots, I'm actually not going to use pure black because it's actually just a little too harsh. So what I'm going to do is mix up my natural black, which is a combination of Prussian blue and raw umber, and I'm adding a little bit of pure black to darken it. And the reason I'm using this mix is it looks more natural and it will stick out less. I've made the paint a little runny and I'm going to apply it with a small flat oval brush. Remember to look at your reference photo and to try and paint what you see. The spots aren't normally round, and I'm going to use that same flicking motion to give the effect that their spots are actually made up of black fur and they're not painted on. Remember also to look at your reference material and look at the type of spots that the animal has. So for instance, between the eyes, they're very small, and where the coat is curving around the back of the head, the spots will appear sort of longer and flatter and more oval. Try to make sure they also look random and they're not really evenly spaced. Last thing I'm going to do is switching to the long-haired brush. I'm just going to add in some white whiskers. So I'm adding them in last because they overlap everything else. So I'm just got some thin white paint and I'm going to flick them in. You've got to try to do it in one confident stroke. Try not to do lots of little strokes or try not to go over it too many times. So that's it, guys. I hoped you liked this tutorial and it was helpful. If it was, please help out Fieldey TV and me by sharing it with anyone you know who would like like to see it. And don't forget to check out more Mad Skills Masterclass tutorials.